Previously on The Bill.
Behave. No happy to naughty boys at Christmas.
Well, no, she's just a mate.
Trying to get rid of me, though?
No, on the contrary.
Well, if I make Sergeant, I'll be transferred.
I wouldn't be so sure.
But if you're really stuck,
I've got a room.
Mate, you have no idea.
Trial basis.
As well. Can you move back everyone now? Thank you.
Locked.
Hello? Can you hear me? Hello, sir? Can you hear me?
Is he breathing?
I don't know. Look, we're going to have to break it.
Okay.
Please, can you just move back?
Thank you.
What's going on? Where am I?
It's all right. I'm Yvonne Hemingway from Sunhill Police Station. Now, we've called for an ambulance, but can you remain in the car until then? You able to tell me your name?
My name? I need to get out of here. My wife!
Hey, hey! I think that's a good idea. Do you? Now, the paramedics are going to be here soon. Look, I'm going to follow the ambulance. Do you want to stay here and see if anybody saw anything? His name's Ian Culloch. He was found beaten and unconscious in his car off Canberra Road just before 7 this morning. We think he might have been there longer than that. It was called in by a John Mercer, shopkeeper in the area.
Canberra Road. Done lots of Tom's work there.
Yeah, but his wallet and his house keys are missing, so it could be robbery. Honey's still at the scene, but no witnesses have come forward so far. She's going to check out the CCTV as well.
Thanks, Yvonne.
Okay.
Sorry, we're keeping you up.
Mr. Culloch, hello. My name is DC Sim. This is DC Perkins.
Hi. This is my wife, Sarah.
Hi. I'm sorry to do this to you right now, but can we ask you a few questions? Why don't you start by telling us what happened?
I was on my way home. It was about 2:30 in the morning. I'd had to work late. I stopped off to buy some cigarettes. There's a 24-hour shop on the Canberra Road. I just got out the car and some bloke asked if I had a light. Before I know it, he's landed me one on the face. Next thing I know, I'm on the floor and he's kicking me. That's about it. I blacked out.
And you got your wallet and house keys, is that right?
I don't remember him doing it, but they were definitely gone when I came round. That's when I crawled into the car and passed out.
Do you think you could tell us what he looked like?
It's hard to say, it was so dark. He was white. About my height, 5'10", brown hair, short.
Anything distinctive? Birthmark, scar, accent?
No, again, just normal. I'm afraid it's all I can remember.
It's fine. Thank you very much for your help. We'll be in touch if we need more information.
A fiver says he wasn't buying fags.
Here you go, Daniel. My treat. What's that?
Application form for the advanced driving course. Deadline's at lunchtime.
Should be okay, though. Don't know anyone else who's applying from Sunhill.
Actually, I've applied. I'll do it this week.
Ah. Oh, well. I mean, if it's between you and me, I've been at Sunhill longer.
Yeah, but I've got more driving experience.
Any units, Sierra Oscar. Deal with a disturbance at the bus stop at the north end of Frankham Road.
See Oscar from 2-1. Show us dealing.
Steve.
Well, we'll have to just see then, won't we? May the best man win.
Would someone like to tell me what's going on?
Yeah, I would. When I got on this bus, it said it was 73 on the front. But halfway through the journey, he decides to go somewhere completely different.
I meant to be going that way. It's the number 42.
Yeah, but it didn't say that, did it?
All right, calm down. We'll sort this out. Look, will you speak to my colleague? Come on.
I should have left a stop 20 minutes ago.
What's your name, please, sir?
Barney Goodman.
quiet, Barney. Do you want to tell me what happened?
I was driving along. Everything was fine. Suddenly she starts getting up fast. This isn't the right way. Where are we going? I tell her it is the right way. I've been driving this route for nearly 20 years. Anyway, it turns out it was the wrong number on the front of the bus. It said 73. Should have said 42. I apologised. My fault. I had to change it. But she wouldn't let it go. And then everyone else started off. Next thing, she stood in front of the bus refusing to move unless I take her where she's paid to go. I can't. I was up tight schedule.
Alright, we'll sort this out.
Look, is there no way you can take them where they want to go?
Right.
How about refunding their fares? I mean, that seems to be what's bothering them.
All right. But I don't know what my manager's going to say.
So what do you think?
Yeah, not bad. Not bad at all.
My sentiments, exactly.
You all right?
Yeah, my boss is in a right state. I should have been at work an hour ago.
Where'd you work?
The petrol station on Breton Street. It's only part-time. I'm a student. But my boss hates students because he thinks we're unreliable.
Well, maybe we can give you a lift.
Really?
No worries.
Thank you. You're stars.
All right. How's it going?
What bad? Annie managed to find this. It's a CCTV from an off-licence on Campbell Road, about 100 yards where Cullock was found.
Hey, it's Cullock, isn't it? See, I told you it wasn't mine first, didn't I? Here's this geezer here.
Haven't got a name for him yet, but look. Money's changing hands.
Uh-huh.
Annie's checking out all the pimps in the area. See if she can get a name for him. You know, I'm thinking maybe we should pay our Mr. Cullock another visit. Speak to him when his wife isn't around. Try and get him to come clean.
Do you mind if I speak to him on my own? He might be less embarrassed if it was like, you know, man to man.
Sure.
Okay, I'll see you later.
See ya.
Here we
go. Sorry. All right?
Yep. Bit tired, you know. Sergeant's exams in a couple of days, remember?
I do now, yeah. You been up all night revising?
Just a little.
Well, maybe it might be worth it in the end.
Mr. Cullock. DC Perkins, remember me?
Yes.
Mind if we have a quick chat?
Will it take long? Only my wife's bringing the car around.
I won't keep you long. We have some CCTV footage that was taken from a shop in Campbell. Mr. Cullock, I need you to be honest with me. Anything you tell me will be kept in the strictest confidence. Your wife need not find out.
I wasn't even going to pursue this, but Sarah...
Do you want to tell me what did happen last night?
I parked up on Antrim Way. Just before two. I've only done it once before. The man approached me, asked if I was looking for some business. I said I was. We agreed a price and he took me over to the woman.
Did you get either of their names?
She took me over the road. There's a building near where I park my car. The girls have rooms. When I left, about 2:30, I was heading back to the car and this guy attacked me from behind.
That description you gave me earlier of the guy that attacked you, was that accurate?
No, the guy that jumped me, I couldn't see his face. He was wearing a balaclava.
Did he speak? Right, well, I've got everything I need. Mrs. Cullock?
Sarge? Can I give my application form for the advanced driving course now?
Yeah. You're cutting it a bit fine, though, aren't you? 15 minutes before the deadline.
If you ask me, he's not taking it very seriously, Sarge.
Yeah, look, I am.
What's that?
What?
Dent. Who booked the car out this morning?
Well, I did, Sarge, but we haven't had a prank.
Well, did you do a vehicle check before you left the Nick? Oh, come on, Will, you know the score. If you booked out the vehicle, it's your responsibility. If you haven't got an explanation, you're looking at 3 penalty points for this.
You said you were going to do it. What happened?
Yeah, look, sorry, I was filling out the application form. I had to get it in before the deadline.
Oh, and in the meantime, you scupper my chances of getting on the course at all. Like, 3 points on your file doesn't exactly inspire faith, does it?
No, I guess not. But never mind, though. You can always apply for the course again. Made a best man win, was it?
How's it going? Well, we've managed to identify the guy in the CCTV.
Good.
And Sonny James.
Okay. He's got form for pimping. Interestingly, always in the West End, never in Canley. Although this is where he lives.
And what about the girl? We've got a name for her?
No, nothing yet, but I'm still looking into it.
How do you get on?
You can give me that fiver now.
You got Cullock to admit he was with a prostitute last night?
I did.
So, how much of what he told us was a lie?
Almost everything. What is interesting is that he now claims that the guy that attacked him was wearing a balaclava.
Think it was planned?
I think that Sonny James has got a scam going. Married punters are vulnerable, aren't they? They're not going to squeal to the police in case the wife finds out.
Well, how about I have a trawl through Chris? See if there have been any other incidents recently with the same MO.
Okay, good. And while you're at it, put a call into the West End Network. Yes, you can get some journal, Sonny James. Hello? Yeah. Right. Yeah, thanks. Well, there's a surprise. The room that Cullock was taken to last night is owned by Craig Fenton, but it's leased to Sonny James.
So, shall we arrest James on suspicion of robbery?
I think we should put some uniform together to do a search. See if anything of Cullock's turns up at Sonny's place.
Hey, I just had a call from Roger. He must be feeling better. He's moaning about the hospital food.
Give the nurses hell, no doubt.
Hey, Reg, have you heard Jimmy Bowden's taken early retirement to France?
Oh, yeah, I did hear. Of course, it means the position's open now. Should anyone be interested in being a Fed rep, you know?
Everyone coming to you with their problems? Sounds too much like hard work.
You don't fancy getting them, Rich?
No, Tony, I don't think I can give up the time now.
No, sorry, forgot about your hectic social life. Rushing home to watch all those tapes of the Discovery Channel. How about you, Will?
Sorry?
All right.
It looks like he's about to pick up 3 penalty points. Not happy bunny, are you?
No, I'm not. Considering it wasn't my fault I got him in the first place.
Mm, sounds like you're both having fun.
Actually, I found it very enjoyable. I'm an attractive young lady I'm thinking about taking out on a date.
What?
Well, I was the first to say I was interested.
Sorry to interrupt. Well, Dan, did you attend a disturbance on a bus this morning?
Oh, yeah. The bus driver had the wrong number on the phone.
Right, well, I've just had a call from a Dave Fairchild. He's the manager of Canley Bus Depot. He reckons one of their vehicles has been stolen. Can you check it out?
Look, I'll drive. Good to get some practice in before the course. All right, you take your break now, and I'll deal with this, OK? Hi there. I'm Dave Fairchild. I manage Depot.
I'm PC Fletcher. This is PC Casper.
Right.
Why don't you tell us what happened?
Sure, yeah. Well, we first noticed the bus was missing about an hour ago during a routine maintenance check. And this is the one that's missing.
That is Reg.
Yeah.
Could one of your drivers taken the wrong bus out by accident?
Well, that's what I thought first. It does happen. But we've checked with all the drivers and none of them can account for where it is.
Where'd you keep the keys?
Keys went out with the ARC. We've all got starter switches now. Now, at the start of each week, each driver gets a rotor, which tells them which routes they'll be driving. They pitch up at the start of the shift, show their pass to the duty inspector, and get a duty log card like this one.
And your inspector can't account for when this happened?
No. I've double checked with her. She's new to this garage, but she's very experienced. And she feels terrible, because this is the first time that she's locked the buses out without me monitoring her.
Could someone have forged a pass?
Mr. Fairchild, does this camera work?
Yeah.
All right, why don't we check this morning's footage, see if there's anyone you don't recognise.
Okay.
Mr. James, can you tell us where you were at 2:30 a.m. this morning?
If you ask nicely.
Please.
Well, honey, how can I refuse? I was at the Crystal Bar on Dumford Street.
Can anyone confirm that?
Lots of lovely ladies all around me. Or you could try Mikey. He owns the place. And I tell you what, I'm pretty sure there's a security camera near the entrance to the gents' toilet that always gets my good side.
So, you weren't pimping at 2 a.m. this morning in the Canberra?
Do I look like a pimp?
Sorry, you weren't setting up business between a man and one of your girls in the Canberra Road this morning?
I've told you, I haven't got any girls. You have the wrong man.
You recognise him? It's you, isn't it? Now, we know who this man is, because 45 minutes after this footage was taken, he was beaten up.
You think about me?
We don't know. We're still trying to decide what happened.
It wasn't me. Phone Mickey. He'll tell you I couldn't have done it.
We will, in due course. In the meantime, maybe you could help us by identifying this woman here?
Don't know her name.
Mr. James, we currently have CCTV footage of you taking money from this man and introducing him to this woman. Now, at the moment, we're investigating a robbery.
Which I've told you I didn't do.
However, we could widen our net and do you for pimping as well, as an added bonus. Now, do yourself a favour and tell us who she is.
Her name's Lee Bevan.
Where does she live?
Greenford Way, 38, flat 3. Now, can I go?
Oh, just yet. I'll get back to you, all right?
I hate to admit it, but he sounds genuine. Flat search hasn't turned up anything. I'll check out his alibi. Do you want to pay Lee Bevan a visit?
Yeah, let's do that.
Sorry, there's a DC Turner asking for you. I've shown him up to CID. He's from West End, Nick. Something about a Sonny James.
Mm-hmm. Okay, thanks, mate.
Tony, you've got 5 minutes for a cup of tea. I wouldn't mind running something by you.
Yeah, sure. What's up?
The Fed rep position. I was thinking.
Have you thought of someone?
You.
Why? Don't you think I could do it?
I couldn't think of anyone better to master the intricacies of our pension regulations.
I did psychology GCSE, so I could help people with their personal problems, offer a friendly shoulder to cry on. Why not me? Tony?
Look, I don't know what Honey Harmon told you, but we just need a little bit of information. We could have done this on the phone.
All right, she was very clear. But me and Sonny James go back a long way. I hear his name, you're going to struggle to keep me away. So, well, you're investigating the assault of one of James's punters, right?
Yeah, that's right. We found this guy, Ian Cullock, beaten up this morning. After a bit of digging, it turns out that Cullock was attacked after leaving some prostitute he'd been with, Lee Bevan.
I know her. Yeah, she's been one of Sonny's girls for a couple of years. Typical story, no job, kid to support, Sonny shows her a way she can make money. Well, she was part of his West End setup until he moved them all out a few months ago.
And he doesn't work that area anymore?
Nope. No, we haven't heard sight nor sound of Sonny James for about 4 months, which is why my ears pricked up when your lot called. See, Sonny James was a regular pimp in the West End for about 3 years. And his girls worked mainly out of flats in Soho, and he had a group of about 20 women who he represented, as he called it.
So what made him move on?
Well, about 8 months ago, this man, Gordon Kite, came on the scene. And previously, he'd worked as a pimp in North London. He was doing very well, supplying prostitutes to rich, coked-up city boys. Kite got ambitious, decided he was going to expand his empire, so he moved into the West End, and he came with a definite "this town ain't big enough for the both of us" attitude. Started running a protection racket amongst the West End pimps. They gave him a cut of their profits just to make sure that none of their punters came to any harm.
So Kite was threatening the punters?
Mm. Which, believe me, is not good for business. Before long, the lower-level pimps either succumbed to sharing their earnings with Kite, or they disappeared.
That's John. That's Derek. He's on the 62 route today. So that's everyone who was scheduled to drive this morning, all accounted for.
Wait a minute, who's that? Isn't that Barney Goodman?
Yeah, it is. He shouldn't be here.
Why not?
He retired 6 months ago.
But we met Barney this morning. Some of his passengers were kicking up a fuss.
He's taking passengers?
Yeah, on the 42 route. He's got his lug card.
What's he think he's doing?
Stuart!
Love. Wonder if I might bump into you.
Good to see you. How are you?
Oh, very well, are you?
I'm fine. So what are you doing here?
DC Perkins and I have found we share a common interest. A pimp called Sonny James. Seems he's decamped from the West End, settled in Sun Hill.
So he's still working in the West End?
Yeah, just past my sergeant's. Still plain old DC, though. Yeah.
Well, congratulations. So how long have you been there?
About 4 years. Been good experience.
Right. Well, I'll leave you to it.
Yeah. Thanks, Gov. We worked together a couple of years back when he came on a job at West End.
Right. Oh, Suzie, this is DC, Stuart Turner. He's just been filling me in on the checkered history of Sonny James.
I just bailed him. His alibi checked out.
Just hang on a sec. Hello? Yeah. Right. All right, thanks, Tony. Apparently, Ian Cullock's just come home to find some geezer unconscious on his floor. Looks like they've used the keys taken in the robbery to get in. They're taking him to hospital now. You want to come along? Hi, Tony.
Sorry, Suzie.
Hi.
Tony, this is DC Turner.
Hi.
This our man?
Yeah. Doctors reckon he overdosed on heroin. Well, they've stabilised him. Story is, Mr. and Mrs. Cullock get home, find Chummy a spark out on the bedroom floor, surrounded by Mrs. Cullock's jewellery.
Any ID on him?
What we've got is a wallet. It's Mr. Cullock's. There's no cash, credit cards are still in there. I do have these.
Now, they're relating to various benefit claims. They're addressed to a Douglas Bevan.
Bevan? Well, either it's a coincidence or it's related to Lee, our prostitute.
Yeah, it's her brother. Looks like it's got nothing to do with the son of your kite.
Situation with Lee's getting more and more interesting. Tony, are you all right to stay here and get some details from him when he comes round?
You want to come along with us?
Thanks, but no thanks. I think it's all a bit routine now. No big fish. I'll leave you to it.
All right.
Thanks, mate. Thanks.
Big fish.
Lee Bevan, DC Sim, DC Perkins, Sunhill. Mind if we have a word? Come through. Thank you. Well, when was the last time you saw your brother?
About 4 days ago. He came knocking on my door at 4 a.m. asking for money. I didn't give him any.
What, you ain't seen him since?
No, why?
He was found unconscious about an hour ago, having overdosed on heroin. He's at St. Hugh's now.
Sounds about right.
Don't seem too bothered by that.
He's a junkie. When he cleans himself up, then he can get sympathy.
Douglas was found unconscious in a house belonging to a man called Ian Cullock. Mr. Cullock was assaulted at 2:30 this morning. His wallet and keys were taken.
Dougie did it.
Well, it looks that way. But what interests us is that Mr. Cullock was attacked after he spent half an hour with you in a room in Antrim Way.
And you think I'm involved, that me and Dougie are in it together?
We don't know. But it seems too much of a coincidence if you're not, don't you think?
Listen, you tell me my brother attacked someone for money, I believe you. He's got a habit and he'll do anything to feed it. But whatever he was doing there had nothing to do with me.
Okay. We'll have to wait and see what he says when he comes round. Excuse me. Hello? Yep. Where is it?
How old's your daughter?
5. Look, I really tried with Dougie. But I've got my little girl to think about. Do you understand?
Yeah, I do. Yeah.
You got kids?
Yep, my daughter's not much younger than you. I didn't see much of her.
So what's your excuse?
Sorry.
Okay. Dads. They're a dying breed.
Terry, we've got to go. Something's come up.
It's up to you.
What happened?
As far as we can gather, there were 6 prostitutes up there, each with a punter. About half an hour ago, 3 guys burst in, all of them wearing balaclavas, carrying baseball bats, and you can see what happened next.
Thanks, Yvonne.
Whoever did this meant business.
Mm. So, what's happening?
Oh, Gov. DC Turner mentioned something about some sort of feud between Sonny James and another pimp called Gordon Kite. As far as he knew, Kite had gone underground.
Looks like he might be back on the scene. Right, let's get hold of Stuart. I want him on board. Where's Sonny James?
I bailed him, Gov.
Well, find him, quick.
I was wondering if anyone else had come forward for the Fed Rep.
I'm expecting a couple of people to, but I did say I'd let you know.
Sure.
Give me strength.
Oh, she'll be good at it.
She's on a mission. She's been quoting police regulations at me, chapter and verse. She looks resolute, positively laid back.
Yeah, but I hope that somebody else stands for election then.
You'd give her a run for her money.
I'd rather chew my own arm off. Terry, I've got that information that you asked for about similar robberies to Mr. Cullen.
Spoke to DC Turner. He's on his way. He should be here in a minute.
Right. Neil, you must let me know what you think about Stuart. You know, he's looking to move on. That's what a DS down. He might be worth considering for our team.
Okay. What about Suzie?
Well, she hasn't got her sergeant's exams, has she?
As good as.
Well, I don't think she's ready for a more supervisory role yet. We need a team player in CID, and I don't think she's it.
He's dead, isn't he? That's why you're here.
No, Mrs. Goodman, your husband's not dead.
A bus from the county depot went missing earlier this morning. You think your husband's taking it?
Have you any idea why he might have done this?
The last few months, he's not been well. It's depression or something. He misses his job. Ever since he retired, he's not known what to do with himself. It was his life. The last 2 weeks, he's been so down. I didn't know what he would do. That's why I thought when I saw you at the door that he might have.
Did Mr. Goodman say anything to you this morning before he left? Give you any indication as to where he was going or what he was going to do?
All units from Sierra Oscar. Disturbance reported at Canley bus
station. It's going to be balmy, isn't it?
Sierra Oscar from 543, show us dealing.
Sorry. Received.
Stuart, it's your DI Manson.
So what have you got, Terry?
Well, Gov, I've just spoken to Tony, and Dougie Beveren has regained consciousness and he's putting his hands up to robbery and burglary at Cullock's. Now, apparently, he's asked the mate to drive him around to his sister so he can borrow some money. When he gets there, he sees the sister disappearing with a punter inside. He decides to change his plan. He borrows a balaclava from a mate.
So it's safe to say that the Cullock robbery is no way associated to the attack at the Entrenway brothel this afternoon.
It isn't, but it might not be the first time Sonny James has been targeted since he's been working in the area.
In the last 2 weeks, three men have been assaulted, all in the surrounding area of Antrim Way, but on Barton Street's patch. None of them had anything stolen. Two of the men, both married, deny having ever been with a prostitute, but we've got CCTV which shows one of them with a well-known Tom, Val Cleaver.
She's one of Sonny's?
Yeah. The third man admits having been with a prostitute. He says he doesn't know her name. But from the description he gave of the pimp, sounds just like Sonny James.
Right. So what do you think, Stuart?
Well, Kite's certainly got a history with Sonny James. And these three attacks do sound similar to what was happening in the West End. What happened this afternoon? It was pretty severe.
Well, maybe Kite's up in the stakes.
Possibly, but that doesn't explain the message. Your next Sonny. It's too personal.
So what are you doing about finding James?
Well, uniform's been around to his house, but there's no sign of him. Are they going to stick around in case he shows up? We've checked all his known haunts, but nothing.
All right, so we'll see what happens. So where do we take it from here?
Maybe we should pay Lee Bevan another visit. She and Sonny have known each other a long time. If he's in trouble, she might know what it is.
Sounds good. Neil?
Yeah.
Right, I'll leave you to it.
Well then, Terry. You can drive.
Oh, happy days.
Hiya, thanks for coming. It's Barney. He's brought the bus back. So the thing is, he won't get off it. It's like he can't hear us.
I'll have a word, yeah?
Barney? I'm PC Wolf Fletcher. Do you remember me from this morning? And all those other stroppy passengers? We saw it out in the end, though, didn't we? Why don't you open the door, eh?
Shouldn't be here.
You really miss it, didn't you? Over 40 years, is that right? A lot to turn your back on.
When I retired, I didn't realise there'd be nothing left.
Come on, Barney, you've not got nothing.
Haven't I? All I know is this is the only thing I'm good at. And I can't do it anymore.
I spoke to your wife, Mary, this morning. She's really worried about you.
She's always worried a bit.
Well, I don't think she knows what to do. She wants to help you, she just doesn't know how. But the next few months, they're going to be difficult to get used to not working. It's going to be a lot easier to get through it if you and Mary stick together. 45 years behind the wheel of a bus. Maybe it's about time you saw a bit more of the world, eh?
You've heard leaders think they're going up for Federation rep.
Yeah, I heard.
I don't know. A visitor.
Terry, you've got a female just gone into Sonny James's house? About 5'6", blonde hair, early 20s. Yeah, okay.
Thinks it's Lee Bevin, one of Sonny James's prostitutes.
Miss Bevin?
It's PC's Ollis and Stanton Sale. What's in the bag?
Oi, 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 oi!
Cute.
Lee, you were seen entering Sonny James's flat on Burgold Street at just after 2 this afternoon. You emerged a few minutes later carrying a sports bag. When searched, a selection of clothes and a gun were found in the bag. What do you have to say?
I didn't know the gun was there.
And what did you think was in the bag?
The clothes. I sometimes do his washing.
Yeah, of course you do. When was the last time you saw Sonny?
Last night, late.
And have you spoken to him since then? We checked your phone, Lee. Called you at 1 this afternoon.
Lee, someone's trying to hurt Sonny. And we'd like to stop that from happening if we can. So if you know where he is, tell us. Look, while he's out there, you're in as much danger as he is. You know what happened in the rooms on Antrim Way.
Sonny didn't tell you. Well, 3 men raided the flats. They beat up 6 of your colleagues and 6 of their punters with baseball bats. Imagine what would happen if they found you and your daughter.
It's okay, Lee. You just, you tell us what you know.
Sonny phoned me, said Gordon Kite was on his tail again and that he was going to lie low for a while. He asked me to go to his flat and pick up a bag. I really didn't know the gun was in there. That's not Sonny's style.
Well, Lee, we reckon this is more than just a protection racket the Kite's running. It feels like he's really gunning for Sonny. Why?
When Sonny moved out of the West End, he took a parting shot at Kite. Kite's got this limo service. I think it's his dad's business. Sonny had the car smashed up.
How are you supposed to be getting the bag to Sonny?
Look, he probably had the gun for protection to scare Kite. He wasn't going to use it.
Look, when people are scared, they do stupid things, you know?
Sonny's been good to me and to Emily.
Well, how is your little girl? She must be about 4 or 5 by now. Have social services checked up on you lately? Because I wonder what they'd make of a prostitute caught up in all this mess.
Yes, come.
Where are you meeting Sonny?
O'clock at my place. You happy?
That's great. Cheers now. Good news. Head office don't want to take it any further. I think they're worried about the bad PR.
Lucky for Barney.
Such a shame. You know, he was great with the public. I swear, there were some old dears would take his route even if it meant putting 10 minutes extra on their journey. I just hope he can get himself back on track.
And thanks for your fair charge. You've been very understanding. The company have agreed not to take any action. Not that they took much persuading. You're leaving behind quite a legacy here. Barney?
I've been so worried about you.
We'll be off then.
Thank you so much. I'm so sorry for all the time and trouble you've had.
No trouble at all. That's a bit of a result.
You did well.
Where should we go and spread our wisdom now then?
How about the garage on Gretton Street?
I mean, I've got a feeling we're conveniently low on fuel.
Don't give up, dear.
Nope.
Come on in. Why don't we toss a coin for it? Winner gets to ask her out.
All right, heads or tails?
Heads. Looks like I'm on the wrong. Come on in, mate. Don't want to leave the good lady waiting.
Leading on a brief from my seat?
Yeah, well, he's welcome to it. I don't like the way this guy operates, I'm telling you.
Got the right result, though, didn't it?
Okay, for those of you who don't know him, thank you. This is DC Turner from West End Central. He's going to be leading this operation.
Okay, situation is, this man, Gordon Kite, we think is on the hunt for this guy, Sonny James. Now, Kite targeted one of Sonny's brothels this afternoon, put 12 people in the hospital. That was just a warning, so we don't know what Kite's intentions are for Sonny himself. Now, 4 o'clock this afternoon, Sonny has arranged to pick up a bag containing some clothes and an automatic pistol from this woman, Lee Bevan. Now, our intention is to let Sonny have the gun, follow him, hope he leads us to Kite. Okay, this is how it's going to work. Lee will wait in the flat with the bag. Now, the bullets have been removed from the gun, so there's no danger of that becoming a threat. Terry, DC Perkins will be waiting in the kitchen, keeping an eye on Lee. Myself and DC O'Meadows will be parked in the OP van across from the flat here. DC Sim, D.I. Manson, will be parked just around the corner in Teasel Road. PCs Hollis and Stamp, parked around the other corner in Sion Road by the garages. The rest of you will be assigned as backup on all the other exits, okay? Any questions?
Why so many bodies for one bloke? Well, if Kite's friends or anything to go by, better safe than sorry. Right, let's get to it.
Right, do you know what you have to do, or do you want to go through it again?
I answer the door and give him the bag. Hardly Shakespeare, is it?
Listen, I'm sorry about what happened earlier. He shouldn't have threatened you with social services. It's obvious you're a good man.
I just want to get this over with. Get you and the rest of your lot out of here.
So who's picking your daughter up from school?
So you're worried about her now?
Look, Leela, I've got a daughter as well, and this job just got in the way.
Can we not talk?
Fine.
Terry, you both ready in there?
Ready and waiting.
Well, we'll let you know as soon as Sonny James appears.
Over.
So how long have we got?
Minus 5-2. Should be here any minute.
It's not a bad result for you, this, is it? Sounds like you've been after James for a long time.
Just a bit. Well, possession of a firearm isn't the ideal charge, but it'll have to do, especially if it leads us to Kite. PC Stamp.
Are you and PC Hollis in position?
Yeah, we're here, over.
I should have brought my books. Could have squeezed in a bit more revision.
Suzie, are you in position?
In position, over. Can I ask you a question? I know it's unprofessional of me, but, has the DCI mentioned whether he's found a replacement for Harmony?
Don't think he's made a decision yet.
Go. Over there.
Right on time. Okay, everybody.
James is 20 yards in front of me and he's heading for the flat.
You hear that?
Stand by.
Just act naturally. Be all right.
Yeah.
Look. Answer the door. Give him the bag. Remember, it's hardly Shakespeare, is it?
Just about out of the building.
We've got a green Cherokee on the estate. And we're following, Anna.
Message received. Keep well back.
It's Kite.
Kite on the plot. He's got a gun.
Sierra Oscar from Sierra Oscar.
Get my hand in the room, Stager. You'll be all right. Go on.
Black jacket has already discharged
firearm. Proceed with caution.
Lee! I've been shot! Lee! It's me! Open the door, quick!
I'm arresting you for attempted murder.
Get up!
Defense, you do not mention any questions, so you later rely on in court. Anything you do say may be given in evidence.
Last one, Terry.
All right. Just about.
If you'll do the honours and fill her up, I'm going to go and reacquaint myself with a lovely Gemma.
Gemma.
Hello again. Can't give away, can you?
Listen, can I give you my number?
Sure.
I was just wondering if you want to meet out for a drink or something.
Yeah, that'd be good.
Yeah?
Okay.
Yeah, that'd be great. When are you working this week?
So you asked her out then?
I gave him a number. She's going to give me a call when she's free.
What are you doing, mate? That's unleaded.
Oh, don't believe it. Did I put the diesel one in?
Well, obviously you didn't.
One's just going to be mental.
We can't drive it now, not till the tank's been cleaned out.
Sarge, it was an honest mistake.
I've been a mobile unit down for hours, all because you don't know how to use a petrol pump.
Sarge.
This is going to cost you 3 points on your permit. You realise that, don't you?
Oh, poor baby. What's the nasty man been feeding you?
I don't believe it.
Oh, mate, it's not the end of the world, is it? At least it'd be a fairer fight now for the place on that course. We've got 3 points each, haven't we?
You think? I've got 3 points already. Add a collision, blues and twos. I'm out, mate. I won't be eligible.
Okay, if you could just listen up. I just want to say well done for today. You kept your heads and you handled the situation calmly. You especially, Telly. Yep. So if anybody fancies a drink, first round's on me.
Well, come. Have a word.
Yeah, I want to have a word with you anyway.
You coming for?
What are you using?
Well, listen, if I don't see you before, good luck.
Thank you.
Terry, fancy a pint? You've earned it.
Oh, sorry, Gov, I've got to meet someone.
Gov. Terry mentioned the name Craig Fenton earlier today. He's been leasing some rooms on Antrim Way to Sonny James. He's a nasty piece of work. Up until about a year ago, he was pimping and dealing drugs on our patch and disappeared. Now, I was wondering if I could stick around for another day or so, see what he's up to.
How about more than just a day? I'm short of a DS, and I'd like you on my team.
Well, I'll think about it.
Good.
Come on, mate, keep your chin up.
It's my own stupid fault.
Actually, it wasn't your fault. No, really, it wasn't. I changed the pumps. When I come out of the petrol station, I saw you chatting up Gemma. It was supposed to be a joke.
What joke? Do you know how much that course meant to me?
Well, I didn't know you were at 3 points, did I, you dozy plonker?
Dozy? Well, mate, you better find somewhere else to sleep tonight. I want you out of the flat.
Mate, it was a joke.
You can pick up your stuff in the morning.
Dan, don't be... Dan!
What's up with Dan?
Oh, I don't know. I think he's just messed up his chances of getting on the advanced driving course. I think I better leave it a while before I go home. He'll give me a right nightmare when he's got a cob on.
Oh, you may. Well, I'd better be getting off.
Oh, don't go. Like, no one likes a drink alone, do they? Especially when they can have a drink with a beautiful lady.
With lines like that, I'm surprised you don't drink alone more often.
Please.
Go on, then. I suppose I'm up for staying out a bit longer.
Good. Well, in that case, I'll get us a bottle in. You stay right where you are. Don't go changing, all right?
Please.
Hi.
Hi, can I come in?
Yeah. Can you give me a minute? I'm just going to put Emily to bed.
Yes.
Mummy's gonna come and check on you. Come on. Here you go. Josie. Come on. Are you keeping your dressing gown on? So what do you want?
I just want to make sure you're all right, that's all.
I'm fine. Is that it?
Listen, I know it doesn't feel like it now, but you've done the right thing. Sonny's out of your life, and that's a good thing.
It would have been nice not to be threatened with having my kid taken away.
You're right. But I've already tried to apologise for that, haven't I?
Oh, that's why you're here. You feel guilty?
Yeah, I do, as it happens. Look, Lee, you're 20 years old, and you're bringing up Emily on your own. And I feel bad because you're trying. Look, I've seen her room. It looks great. You're doing a good job.
Thanks. I appreciate it. So you've got kids, but you don't see them. What happened?
That's complicated.
Oh, my life isn't. It's as complicated as you make it.
Anyway, I just want to say sorry.
Well, maybe you're saying sorry to the wrong person.
Emily Bevan, what are you doing still out of bed, young lady? It's time for... Are you going to go back to bed?
No.
Yes, you are. Come on, baby girl. Shall we take...
Get out!
We bought that you didn't know about the gun yesterday, but you better change your tune today.
You're a big girl, aren't you?
Easy, Tiger.
You feeling confident about your sergeant's exam?
There's an opening in the department I'm hoping to get.
Dad, you can't disappear for 2 years and then turn up out of the blue on my birthday. It's not fair.